I had one more request for a division problem involving decimals. So the first step here is to set this up as a long division problem. So 3.8356 divided by 8.6. The first step is we want the divisor to be a whole number. So we'll move the decimal point to the right one place to make this 86. And we can do this as long as we move the decimal point to the right once in the dividend. So we'll move the decimal point from here to here in our dividend, and then move it straight up into our quotient. Now that we have the decimal in the correct position, we can go ahead and ignore the decimal points and perform long division as we normally would. So we look at this as 86, and look at this as 38,356 with the decimal point right here. So we want to know how many 86s there are in. Well, 38's not large enough, so now we look at 383. How many 86s in 383? Not an easy question, but I know that 2 times 86 would be 172, so let's try a 4. 4 times 6 is 24, carry a 2. 4 times 8 is 32 plus 2, that's 34. Remember, as long as this difference is less than 86, this 4 is correct. So now we'll subtract. 13 minus 4 is 9. 7 minus 4 is 3. 39 is less than 86, so the 4 is correct. And now we bring down the next digit. And now we want to know how many 86s there are in 395. Well, 4 times 86 was 344. I think that'll work again. Let's try the 4. Again, 4 times 86 is 344, the same as last time. We subtract. We have 1. 5, so we have 51, which again is less than 86, so that's good. And now we're going to bring down the last digit. So we have 516. We want to know how many 86s there are in 516. Well, if 4 times 86 was 344, let's try 6. 6 times 6 would be 36. Now we carry a 3. And 6 times 8 is 48 plus 3, that's 51. And this works out perfect because this difference is 0. So this is our quotient. So 3.8356 divided by 8.6 is equal to 0.446. Notice I put a 0 in the ones place value. You'll almost always see a decimal written that way.